My name is Amanda Hayek. I am from Dayton, Ohio, originally, but I have worked in this research lab for almost 2 years now under Dr. Dupont, and that's whose lab we're in right now. Right now, I'm actually honored to be a American Physiological Society Stride Fellow. This summer, I was employed and came here every day, worked full time. And during the school year, I am doing an independent study and actually working as well as going to school. And it's been really fun. I like it. So both of my parents are in the science fields. My mom is an occupational therapist, which is how I got on the track of potentially wanting to be a physical therapist. And then my father does nutrition research with animals. I actually came to UK originally as a voice major. I graduated high school with the Conservatory of the Arts. I had done theater all my life, and I was convinced I was going to be going to Broadway. I definitely became a love for science as I got more involved and did a 180 and switched my major freshman year once I got involved with the sciences. So I am a human health science major, which was new my freshman year on the physical therapy track. I also am planning on getting a minor in health advocacy, a certificate in clinical management, as well as a certificate in research. I think the most driving force of especially going into physical therapy is an international service opportunity I had 2 years ago where I went down to Cusco, Peru and worked in a disabled orphanage with children. And while I was there, I experienced something I've never done before, and I got to see the impact I was having and helping with the physical therapy with the children. And to this day, I use that as my inspiration to get through all the hard sciences. And it reminds me that I'm not doing this for a grade, I'm doing it for the people that I'm gonna be helping. My PI, Dr. Dupont, she has done amazing things to further my education as well as appreciation for science, and especially in the research field. And she has given me amazing opportunities, such as the one to be a Stride Fellow through the APS, and as well as many different opportunities that I would never have known if I didn't have such a great mentor as Dr. Dupont. So I am looking at the mechanical effects of massage on atrophied muscle, specifically the gastrocnemius. And what I'm looking at is the cell proliferation of satellite cells, endothelial cells, macrophages, specifically ED2s, as well as fibroblasts. We have actually seen an increase in DNA synthesis with massage, but what we're identifying is if the muscle is actually damaged with massage, as well as which of those cells were involved in that DNA synthesis. Basically, we're just trying to figure out what massage is doing to the muscle. Is it aiding, is it depleting or diminishing? What is it doing when we massage the muscle? And basically what we're finding is maybe with massaging for ICU patients, it could actually prevent atrophy from happening. There isn't a whole lot that we know mechanically behind massage, and that's actually why I find it really cool, is because who doesn't love a massage? And it's really cool to see what it's actually doing on a physiological standing. The most exciting aspect of my research is seeing how it applies to like clinical settings and being able to see how what I'm doing here will in fact benefit the other fields and what I want to do in the future. So the most challenging part is I actually have a lot of health issues. I have quite an extensive medical health record. Right now I am dealing with a hemiplegic migraine or complex migraine, which mimics stroke-like conditions. So I am on medication so that I can feel the right side of my body so I can talk to you. And it's been rather difficult. I've been going to many different doctors for it. The lab here, the people I work with are really understanding, and they've been able to help me deal with these issues. And I wouldn't have been able to do what I do if it wasn't for the people that I have in my life that are a supporting system. And I know what it is like in certain situations to go through some pretty serious medical conditions, but still come out okay on top of it. Research is always asking why things occur, and I get to look at why I have the symptoms that I have, and it's really interesting, and obviously I'm no doctor. I have no experience in really diagnosing, but it helps me understand what's going on with me, and it's not as difficult to deal with it when you understand what's going on.
Thank you.